Good evening everyone and welcome back to our channel. I am Twinkle Quatra from IME Law College and currently a legal intern at Lexis & Company. And today the topic that I am going to start is offenses related to religion. So as we all know that India is a very vast country and it has so many religions. And also our country believes in unity in diversity, right? And also this was watched by our commission as well, and they felt that because India is a very vast country and practice religion on a wider basis, so there should be a section related to religion so that no one can insult anybody's religion, as it should be considered as a crime, and the people who are insulting or causing annoyance to anybody's religion, they should be punished. Also, our constitution gives us article from 25 to 30 that are related to religion. And also guys, it should be our moral duty not to insult anybody's religion, because they are their practices and beliefs are their freedom. People can practice any religion they want. So let's just today discuss that what are the section and what are the punishment if someone will cause annoyance or someone will harm to anybody's religion. So chapter 15 of IPC deal with offenses related to religion. There are total 5 sections, that is 295 to 298. So section 295 says, 295 is injury or defiling place of worship with intent to insult the religion of any class. So it says that if someone will destroy, damage or defiles any place of worship with the intention to cause harm to that worship place and to the religion of the person, and he knows that if he will do this act will cause harm to that person, then that person will be liable for fine and for 2 years of jail or both. This is stated under 295. Now let's come to 295A. There is section, it says deliberate and malicious act intended to outrage religious feeling of any class by insulting its religion or religious belief. It says that if someone with bad or malefied intention will insert anybody's religion or its religion belief by any gesture, by words that could be spoken or written, and by any visible gesture that can be seen, he will be punished under section 295A for the term, that is for 3 years, and also he will be liable to fine or both. Now let's come to section 296. It says disturbing religious assembly. It says that if someone will disturb a religious assembly in which people are engaged in worship and that person disturb that maliciously, then he will be under punishment for 1 year or fine or both. Next is 297. It says trespassing or burial on burial places. It says that if someone will intentionally wounding the feeling of any person or of insulting the religion of any person, or with the knowledge that the feeling will that the act he will do or she will do that will insult the feeling of that person, or he commits the offense or trespass to the worship place or any place where the dead bodies are buried, or any place that where the last rites, funeral rites are conducted, then or he does that act to the dead body, or he disrespects the dead body also, then he will be under punishment of 1 year and fine or both. And last section is section 298. It says uttering words etc. with deliberate intent to wound religious feeling. It means that if someone will utter any word against the religion of that person, or he or she makes any sound, or he or she keeps any object, or one more thing is that makes any gesture in the sight of that person, if he does these 4 things, then also he will be under punishment of 1 year and or fine or both. So these were the section 295, 295A, 296, 297, 298. These were the 5 sections in offenses related to religion, and I hope you understand this video. And obviously the conclusion here came that we should not disrespect anybody's religion, because it should be our moral duty to respect each other religion, and we should always support brotherhood, and we should all not fight over religion. And if we will not do this, then we may leave China behind, and we will be the best country in the world. So it depends upon the people of the country, what they think and what they do. And in all the religious book also, it is written that no other religion should be harmed. Or अपना religion इतना भी ऊपर मत उठा लो कि दूसरे religion को तुम नीचे गिरा दो. हमेशा respect करनी चाहिए. That is the religious book says. So that's it for this video. And I hope you like this video. This was a very short and brief video. And if you have any doubt, you can comment me down below. I will reply it. And also keep liking, keep sharing, and subscribe to our channel.